Graders, and welcome to your next math lesson. I'm Miss Diorio from Citizenship Academy, and we are moving on to lesson 9 today. So in this lesson, we're going to kind of compile or put together everything we've been working on with the vertical method of adding. And instead of using our place value discs, we're just going to use drawings today. So all you're going to need for your lesson today is paper, pencil, something to write with, something to write on. I'm going to be using my notebook today, so that I can see all my work and I have tons of space to write it out. But you go ahead and grab whatever you need, and then we will get started. Ready? Okay, so let's, for our fluency practice, we're gonna work with place value, just because it's gonna be really helpful for the rest of our lesson if we review this. So first thing, I want you to say this number in standard form. Remember, that's when you just say the number. So what number is this? 352. Perfect. Now say it in unit form. Tell me how many hundreds, how many tens, how many ones. Good. Three hundreds, five tens, two ones. Now take that unit form and turn it into expanded form. Remember, that's when we turn each value, each place value, into a number sentence by adding them together. So tell me that number in expanded form, that number sentence. Very good. So it's going to be 300 plus 50 plus 2. We're taking the value of each place and adding them together. So we have 352. How would we say this number the say 10 way? Three hundreds, five tens, two. Good. What is 20 more than 352? Think about how many tens are in 20 and how we would add that into there. 20 more than 352. 372. Awesome. So we're adding two more tens. So if we have five tens, six tens, seven tens. So 300, seven tens, two is 372. Very good. Okay. What is 20 less? This time you're going to take 20 less away from 352. Solve it the same way. What number would that be? Good. 332. So we're going to take just that tens place. We're going to take away two tens, and we get 332. What is 100 more? 432. Awesome. Just changing that hundreds place. What is 100 less? Just change the hundreds place, we get 252. Awesome work. Okay, now I want you to take out your paper, take out your pencil. We're going to practice using the vertical method and our place value chart, but by drawing our place values. So instead of using the place value test, when I make a drawing. So when you make a drawing, as I said with your place value discs, it's very important that you line them up in groups of five. So see how we have 34, 3 tens, 4 ones, and 18 down here is 1, 10, 8 ones. See how I lined up my 8 into 5 groups? That way it's easy for us to kind of see what the number is and how we can group to make 10. So on your paper right now, I want you to pause and I want you to make this. Show me the vertical form and then make the place value chart with the dots. Okay? Show me 34 and 18 with drawings on a place value chart on your paper. Say pause and do that now. Got it? Okay, so your paper should look like this, right? So our next step is to figure out how many ones we have and how many tens we have. How many ones do we have? We can add 4 plus 8. We can see 4 plus 8 in here. How many ones do we have? We have 12 ones, or 1 10 and 2 ones, right? So what we want to do is move those tens over. Because we're not using place value discs anymore, I'm going to have you circle a group of 10. So go ahead and circle that group of 10 on your paper right now. Good. So once we have that group of 10 circled, we're going to draw an arrow to show that we're moving it over to the tens place, and then we're going to draw another circle on our 10 side. So go ahead and make your paper look like mine. We have a group of 10 circled. and then we're drawing an arrow, and we're adding another dot on the 10 side to show that we have another 10. Perfect. Okay, so when we move that group of 10 over, just like we did in our last lesson, we have to make sure we add this 1 onto our vertical number sentence, onto our vertical form. Because we added a 10 over here, we need to make sure that we add it in our vertical form so we don't get confused and we don't miss it. So go ahead and add that 1 on your vertical form. Our next step is how many 1s are left over? How many 1s are not in the circle that you did, that you drew? I have 1, 2 1s left over. So I'm going to add a 2 here in our 1s place because we have 2 1s left over. And then how many 10s do we have? Make sure you count that new unit in that you drew over. We have 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. We have 5 10s. So 34 plus 18 is what? 52. Awesome. All right. We're stepping it up a notch. We are going to now add with that hundreds place. So on your paper, I want you to write in vertical form 134 plus 18. Then I want you to show that on a place value chart. So you're going to need 3 columns, hundreds, tens, and ones. You're going to draw these. We're not using place value discs anymore. You're going to draw it. So you're going to draw 100, 3 tens, 4 ones, and then you're going to draw 1, 10, and 18 for 18. Again, make sure you draw it in the 5 group, like in a 10 frame, 5 group type of thing, so that you can easily see how many are there. And make sure you leave a little bit of a space in between, so that you see the 134 plus the 18. Okay, so go ahead, pause, and do that on your paper now. Good? Okay, here we go. We have our setup. How many ones do we have? Yeah, we have 12 ones again, or 1, 10, and 12 ones. So what can we do with that? We have more than 10 in there. What should we do? Absolutely. Go ahead and circle 10 of those ones on your paper. So we have a group of 10. Now we're going to draw an arrow, and we're going to draw another 10 in that 10 square. We're taking these 10 ones and we're moving them over. So go ahead and do that on your paper. Now, when we do that, what do we need to do to our vertical form? Good. Add that 1. Make sure you write that 1 in your tens place. Be careful not to write it over in the hundreds place. Make sure it's in your tens place here. Okay, so we have hundreds, tens, ones. Make sure it's in your tens place. All right. Now, how many ones do we have left over? Perfect. So we're going to write that in our ones place on our vertical form. How many tens do we have now? Good. We have 5 tens, right? So we're going to write that in there. Make sure you add that other 10 in there. And then how many hundreds do we have? Did we add anything to our hundreds? No, right? We still have 100. So as long as there's nothing in there, we just carry that 1 down. We still have 100. So 134 plus 18 is 152. Good job. All right. Let's try this one. Go ahead and write 114 plus 37 on your paper. And then show me that by drawing a place value chart and the little discs. Draw it, don't use your place value discs. So go ahead and create that on your paper now. Pause and do that. Come back when you're done. Okay, I'm gonna have you do the next steps on your own. So you're gonna count your ones. You're gonna find a group of 10, scooch them over, write it in here. Solve for ones, tens, hundreds, and then unpause, and we're going to go over it. Got it? Okay, let's go over it. So how many ones did you end up with? Once we finished our drawing, we had 11 ones. So I'm going to circle 10 of those ones, and I'm going to draw an arrow and move it over our tens place. Okay, how many ones? Oh, I forgot a step. When I move it over, what do I need to do? Draw a 1 in my tens place. I'm going to make sure that it's in my tens place. Okay, now that I did that, how many 1s do I have left over that are not in my circle? Just 1. Good. And then now how many tens do I have? Yeah. Whoop, I have 5. And then did my hundreds place change at all? No, that stayed the same. We're all good. So now we're at 114 plus 37 equals 151. Awesome job. Thumbs up if you got that. Good job. All right. So I want to get us into our exit ticket. What you're going to do on your exit ticket today is draw a place value chart on your own piece of paper, just like we did in the lesson. And then you're going to draw the chips just like we did in the lesson. Okay? You're going to draw the chips to represent 123 plus 16. Then your next step is to add the ones, bundle a group of 10, move them over with the arrow, count, solve it on the vertical form, and write your answer down. I did this multiple choice. Be careful with some of the choices because some of them are meant to trick you. So be careful when you're moving your group of 10 over that you draw that dot in there and you write that 1 down so you don't miss any tens. Okay? I don't want you to get the wrong answer because you missed a group of 10 like I almost did. So solve for each of these. Draw the picture out. Circle your 10 ones. Scoot them over. And then this last one here is I drew a little hundreds, tens, ones chart. This top number is your first number. This bottom number is your second number. I want you to tell me which one of these number sentences best shows this, is best shown with this place value chart. Okay, excellent job today. Make sure you do all your work on your place value chart, and I will see you guys tomorrow.